Hi, I'm Max, and today we're going to talk about ball valves. A ball valve is a quarter-turn valve that is typically used for on and off flow control. By means of rotating the ball, the inner bore closes or opens to allow the liquid or gas to flow through. Ball valves have a long life and are very reliable, even if they haven't been used for some time. This makes them more common and more popular than, for example, a butterfly valve or a gate valve. They're also very resistant to dirt, which means that they are used for a large number of applications. Manual control is by far the most common form of operation, but electric or pneumatic control with an actuator is also possible. In this video, we will talk about the design, construction, and the various housing and sealing materials used in ball valves. First, the design. A ball valve can have 2, 3, or even 4 connection ports. Most ball valves are two-way and operated with a manual lever. The lever control simply opens or closes the flow from inlet to the outlet. Three-way ball valves usually have an L-shaped or T-shaped bore. This allows for different circuit functions, such as mixing, directing, or distributing flows. Four-way ball valves typically have 2 input ports and 2 output ports, allowing for 4-way flow control. Second, the construction. A ball valve is constructed with 1, 2, or 3 pieces. One-piece designs are the cheapest, and the 2 parts that enclose the ball are pressed or welded against each other. Two-piece valves can be disassembled for repairs, cleaning, or inspection. Often the 2 parts are screwed together. Three-piece valves are often clamped together via bolt joints and can easily be overhauled or thoroughly cleaned in the pipe itself. As a result, they're popular in, for example, the food industry or for sanitation applications. The bore or DN value indicates the diameter of the bore in the ball. Ball valves with a maximum diameter are called full bore, and ones with a smaller diameter are called reduced bore. A full bore means that you experience little to no pressure drop from inlet to outlet. And finally, the materials that make a ball valve. The housing itself usually consists of brass, stainless steel, or PVC. And brass is durable and suitable for most applications, but it's prone to corrosion. Stainless steel is durable, inert, and corrosion resistant, but relatively expensive compared to brass. And PVC is a lot cheaper and also corrosion resistant, but can only be used up to a limited pressure. PTFE, NBR, FKM, and EPDM are often used as sealing materials. We made a separate video about the different sealing materials and click the video over here or check out the description for more information. If you have any questions about ball valves or any other product, then please contact me or anyone else from Tameson.